Hey, yo, CNC stuff. Give me a second to explain what the deal was with that live stream from last Saturday. This video is only going to be about that. If you want regular content, just skip this one and come back tomorrow. So why am I making another video about it? Because that's basically the only way to reach people. Not everyone follows me on Twitter or Facebook. Maybe it would be a good opportunity to do that now. But really, the only way to get stuff like this out there is the same way the original stream went. So YouTube. Okay, what happened? I built the CNC mill 1, again, horrible name. I built that live on Saturday, everything was going fine, and then I failed to get it running. I would like to point out that this is not the machine's fault. The mill 1 was actually doing much better than I was expecting it to, considering it's this janky looking aluminum and MDF box with a few 3D printed parts thrown in. But to get back on track, I ended that stream just when we were getting close to climax. I know that some of you walked out of that stream with blue balls. I'm sorry for that, but hey, that's life. Sometimes you've just got to take it. But with all that, I would like to point out a thing. I am human, you know, I'm flesh and bones, you know, a person. And that person is all that's keeping this channel running. There's no production manager and viewer experience director. This is just me. Like, in a regular video, I have time, I can do retakes, I can edit things. If you didn't know, I actually script all my bigger videos beforehand. But a live stream, that's the exact opposite of that. Live streams stress me out, like seriously, I enjoy doing them, but they are absolutely the most stressful moment of my week. Every single one, because, you know, I have so many things to keep in mind. Cameras, lights, audio, streaming software, chat, there's a lot of it. But at the same time, there has to be some actual content too, building stuff, you know? That is like the job of four people usually, compressed into one. So, you know, normally that is fine, I can deal with tech issues. But what's really hard for me to handle is stalemates, where there's just nothing of interest happening for a while. I feel like that last quarter of the stream was exactly that. And what also didn't help was people in chat smartassing about shit when some of them clearly had no idea what they were talking about. I can only take so much. So yeah, plug pulled stream over. It was not doing justice to this machine anymore, so that was the only possible conclusion. Plus, it was 12:30 a.m. past midnight, and this thing with the Makita router is noisy as all hell. Now, what I don't get are reactions like, dude, you're so unprofessional, you suck, I'm gonna downvote this next stream too, because f*** you. Like, seriously, come on, what? Do I look like a Fortune 500 TV studio to you? I mean, I tried to make it look like that, but just give me a break. Are you seriously gonna get mad at me when the next day I decide not to ruin yet another stream by stopping in my tracks every 2 minutes to explain that stream before it? I did explain the topic once in that stream, but, you know, of course people are gonna keep asking the same things, like, how often have I been asked about the Anet A8 or Core XY geometry? So please, excuse me, if my mods, thank you by the way, you were doing a great job, if my mods try their best to tone down the topic a bit. So if you would kindly remove your downloads from the Einscan stream that have nothing to do with the stream itself, I would greatly appreciate that. Because right now, that's another stream that's sitting at over 10% downloads, which to me says, that is content that should be immediately removed from the channel because it sucks and people don't want to waste their time watching it. I feel like it was a good stream. Please don't ruin that for me too. But you know, that was the exact reason why I pulled the CNC stream in the first place. I was getting ton of shit in the comments, and again, it was over 10% downvotes. So what am I to do? Just leave it up there? Whatever. I've cut the entire end off that stream, which is just pointless fiddling with software that is not going to work anyways. I've put it back up in that edited form on this channel because some folks were asking for it. The full recording, unedited, is up on the Tom3D Live channel, which is a content dump for lesser content like this and was intended for like behind the scenes live stream, etc. So if you want to go watch it, feel free to do that. I'll figure out something about what I should do next with the CNC Mill 1. I don't know, a full separate stream for the first cut seems pointless, but I hope you can stop asking about what the deal with the stream was now, okay? Hey, and on a positive note, this video was shot in 4K 50p on my new Panasonic GH5. Thanks, Griffin Hammond, for getting me hooked. For all three of you still watching, did you like the look? Should we go back to 25 frames? Too realistic? Too TV-like? Let me know. Thanks.